Hello, I'm Dr. Avinder. This is a series of video lectures on microprocessors and microcontrollers. In the today's lecture, we'll be discussing about the pin diagram of the 8085 microprocessor. The topics that I'll be covering up in this video tutorial is one, 8085 IC, its physical appearance, how does it look, how to identify this IC, which side are the starting of the pins, and where is the end pin. Second, we'll be discussing about the classification of the signals. All the pins or the periphery of the 8085 microprocessor are classified into different signals, what those classifications are, and what are the signals under each classifications that we will be seeing in this topic. Today, we'll be discussing about the pin definitions of the 8085. What do the each signal or each pin means? What does it do? That will be the third topic of the video lesson. Let's see the first topic. The first topic is the physical appearance of the 8085 IC. How does it look? How to identify the pins? In the figure, you are seeing the physical appearance in a package, the 8085 IC. You can read it on this IC. It is written 8085A. So this is identification number for this IC. Also, what do you see on this physical IC? That on each side of this DIP, 12 inline package. DIP is 12 inline package. So on this DIP of 8085 microprocessor, there are 20 pins on each side of the microprocessor. So how to identify the starting and the end or any other pin of 8085 is you hold the IC with the notch which is cut somewhere in the middle, or in some ICs there is a dot in one of the corners. So with that dot in the corner or with this notch at the center, hold it upside right with the notch up, or with the dot which is appearing at some corner to be in the upside. Then the pin number one is, when you hold it upside with the notch up, pin number one is onto left of yours, or the pin number one is just adjacent to the dot marking in that corner. So wherever the dot corner is, just beside it you will find the pin number one. Or if you see this notch, onto the left side of this notch is the beginning of the pin number one. So starting from this pin, then go on counting pin number one, pin number two, three, four, five, six, seven, and up to 20. So to the left of this IC, there are 20 pins numbered from pin number one to pin number 20. Then go to the right side. So right side down is the pin number 21. Go on counting pin number 21, 22, 23, and till the end pin number 40. So thus, these are the 40 pins, 20 on both sides of this DIP. So once we know that 8085 microprocessor IC is a 40 pin IC, then we can classify these 40 pins into different signals. What these classifications are, broadly speaking, the classifications are the power and the frequency signals, the address and the data signals, the status and the control signals, the interrupt and the externally initiated signals, and the serial communication signals. So let's now begin up in classifying and describing these different signals. So we have seen that there are 40 pins on the IC, 20 on each side of the IC. So which is the power signal and which are the frequency signals? This we can identify from the chip. So let us see the functions and the classifications. So once these are known to you, that you have five this broad classification of the signals, and these five broad classifications are the power and the frequency signals, address and the data bus, the status and the control signals, the interrupt and the externally initiated signals, serial communication signals. So just by looking at these different names, we can know what these signals will be. So power and frequency signals are related to the power requirements and the frequency requirements of the signals. The address and the data signals are related to how you address the memory locations and at those addresses whether some kind of data is to be transferred from the memory to the processor or from the processor to the memory. So those data will travel over the data bus. Status indicates the operation, what is going on, or once certain bit patterns are selected, what will happen within the IC. So those set of signals on the status lines will indicate the operation that will be going on in the microprocessor. And control signals controls what kind of action can happen within, whether a read operation will take place or a write operation will take place or a memory fetch operation will take place. The interrupt and the externally initiated signals are related to when some external event occurs. How do the processor knows that an event has occurred? How this will respond to it? So this is all defined here in the interrupt and the external initiated signals. Then the data may come in parallel, that is through the data bus, or data can be received one bit at a time, that is serially, over the serial communication interface. So 8085 signals are classified in these five classifications. Let me repeat again these classifications: power and the frequency signals, address and the data bus signals, the status and the control signals, interrupt and externally initiated signals, and the serially or serial communication signal. So these five classification of the signals, they are from these different pin names. So as can be seen that each pin, starting from pin number 1 top right to pin number 20 at the bottom left corner, and from 21 bottom right corner to up 40. So each pin has been named, and these names are all those that is these signals are five classification of the signals. So what is required now is to assign these names in each of these classifications. So let us now see all those signals, their definitions, what exactly they do, and try to relate these with these different classes of the signals. So what is our task now is to define or give a definition to each of the pins and classify those pins as per these five classifications. So we proceed further in classifying these different 40 names which are written here as X1, X2, reset, and so on up to VSS, then A2, then we have the S0 and so on up to the VCC. So putting them in certain classes. So let's now See, the power and the frequency recordings, or the frequency signals. Power signals and the frequency signals. We have seen in the previous diagram, when we saw these names to each of the pins, what do you see here? Pin number 40 is assigned to VCC. This is where the plus 5 volt will be connected. So 8085 operates on a single plus 5 volt power supply. So the power requirement here is, this pin is connected to VCC, that is pin number 40, and diagonally down, pin number 20 is connected to VSS, that is a ground, sink. So power requirement is ground to pin number 20 and VCC plus 5 volt to pin number 40. So this is the power requirement, power signals. The frequency signals are the pin number 1 and 2, where it is written as X1 and X2, and another signal at pin number 37, which is written as a clock out. So in the figure on the next slide, we have shown these signals, leaving all these aside. So as you can watch here, we have specifically shown here pin number 40 to VCC, pin number 20 to ground, pin number 1 and 2 written as X1 and X2. This is where your external crystal oscillator will be connected. So internally, the 8085 divides this frequency by 2. So that means, if we say 8085 operates at 2 megahertz, then a crystal of 4 megahertz is connected on these lines X1 and X2. So as to give a half, that is 2 megahertz required for the 8085 operation. Then you have a clock out signal. This clock out signal is used to connect as clock input to the other peripheral devices that may be connected over the 8085 microprocessor. So we see that the power signal are to VCC and ground, pin number 40 and pin number 20. The clock is connected on X1 and X2, where external quartz crystal oscillator will be connected here. Double the frequency as required by the 8085, because there is an internal clock divider which generates a divide by 2 frequency for the 8085. And the clock out fifth signal, which is as a clock input to the other external peripherals. So this is all these 5 signals will fall under the 8085 power and the frequency signals. The second type of classification was the address and the data bus signals. 8085, the definition says it processes as per the instructions stored in the memory. So it operates on the data as per the instructions which are stored in the memory and produce the result. This means what? The processor has to read the instructions from the memory, interpret them, and then prepare the ALU for a particular operation. So this operation of reading, the instructions are stored one after another in the memory. So an address of the memory locations where the instructions are stored is required to be generated. So that address is generated by the microprocessor. So 8085 is or generates 16-bit address. That means with the 8085, we can address 64 kilobyte of the memory. 2 power of 16 is equal to 16. 2 power of 16 is equal to 64 kilobyte of memory. So this is the highest, largest memory that can be addressed by the 8085 microprocessor. Then once the addresses are generated, from the selected address, the data will be read into the processor or the result will be transferred from the processor back to the memory. So it is mandatory for the processor to read or write onto the memory or to read or write onto the I/O devices. It is required to have some kind of addressing mechanism. And once the addresses are there, then the data can be transferred serially or parallelly, over the data bus. So when you look at the part of this 8085 IC here, you can clearly see from pin number 12 to pin number 19, the associated names are AD0 to AD7. Then on to the right, pin number 21 to 28, the associated names are A8 to A15. A close look at the left side of these pins reveals that the pin definition for these 8 pins are A, D0 can be split into two, address and the data. So these lines are multiplexed. But in real world, these are demultiplexed. Means at one time, they will carry the low part of the address. At another time, they will carry only the data. So these low order buses are to be separated in the real world, so that the 16 address lines are separated from these 8 data lines. If these buses were not multiplexed, we would have required 24 pins, 16 for the address and 8 for the data. But because of this multiplexing, we have saved 8 pins. That means we have ultimately saved the size of the microprocessor. Saving a pin means saving the size and hence saving the cost. That is what the logic behind it. So in a nutshell, the 8085 has 16 address lines. The low order address is from 12 to 19, A0 to A7, and the high order address is A8 to A15. So put together, A0 to A15 is the 16 address lines. And at D0 to D7, the same pins 12 to 19, they are also used to carry the data. So the 8085 address and the data bus are nothing but it is 16 address lines A0 to A15 and 8 data lines D0 to D7. Named AD0 to AD7 because they are multiplexed. They are dual function. And this duality has to be removed in the real world, where the address is separate and the data is separate. Then moving to the third type of classification, which is called as interrupt signals and externally initiated signals. Interrupt signals help the peripherals to communicate with the microprocessor. This is one of the very good mechanism wherein the slow operating devices or the peripherals, they can communicate by sending an interrupt signal to the processor. The processor is a very precious resource. We do not want processor to look for the devices. When are they going to be ready? But instead, we want devices to communicate with the processor whenever they are ready. So this communication will be in the form of an interrupt signal. On the 8085 IC, there are 5 interrupts and 1 interrupt acknowledge. What these 5 interrupts are? These 5 interrupts are, as you can see on this figure, which is drawn as a partial cut view of the 8085. You have pin number 6 assigned to the interrupt called as a trap. Then RST 7.5 to pin number 7. RST 6.5 to pin number 6, RST 5.5 to pin number 9 and INTR to pin number 10. These five interrupts are broadly classified in two categories as vectored and non-vectored interrupt, which we'll be describing in detail in the next lectures. But of now, we can understand that these five interrupts are basically divided into two categories: vectored interrupts, so TRAP, RST 7.5, RST 6.5, RST 5.5. These four are the vectored interrupts. Their ISR address is pre-known to the system, whereas the INTR is a non-vectored interrupt. So the interrupting device, whichever device wish to request the service of the exit file, it also has to send its vector address, the device address. Since their addresses are not known to the microprocessor, so INTR pin is called as a non-vectored interrupt pin. We'll see these definitions in detail in the future classes. Then we have the INTR connected on pin number 10, which is a non-vector. INTA is pin number 11. INTA is an interrupt acknowledged. It is a low enabled pin. So whenever the device receives an interrupt on any of these pins, the 8085 sends a low signal on this pin number 11, indicating that it has seen the request and this is the acknowledgement for that request. So these are the interrupt signal. Onto the right side of the chip, pin number 39, pin number 38, pin number 36, pin number 35. These four pins are assigned to externally initiated signals. What these four pins are? Let's see the definition. The pin number 39 and 38, which is written as a hold and HLDA. These two pins are basically used for some kind of controllers like direct memory access controller, DMA controller. The purpose of this DMA controller is to delineate the system buses so that the data transfer between the memory and the IO can take place. So whenever there is some kind of a memory communication to take place between the IOs and the memory, then the DMA controller sends a signal on this pin hold to the microprocessor. That means it requests to the processor to kindly complete your current going on execution and then give the control of the buses to me. That is the DMA controller. So once the processor is ready, the processor will send an acknowledgement on this line HLDA to the controller that okay, now I am giving the control of the buses to you and over to you now. You can do your activity. So this is what exactly the hold and the HLDA pin will do. Then pin number 36 is the reset pin. This reset pin is an externally input, like when you press a switch onto your system, the system restarts. Restarting or resetting the pin means your all the internal registers, including your program counter, they will go to its default states. They will then contain their default values. And hence we say the system is reset. And finally, the signal called as a ready. This ready signal is for a slow or the peripheral devices for the purpose of synchronization. This helps this synchronize the peripherals with the processor. So this is about the interrupt and the externally initiated signals. Then coming to the status and the control signal. Status indicates what kind of operation might be going on in the processor, and control indicates how you want your processor to act. This is what the basic difference between the status and the control signals are. So if you see the signals here, the control signal, IOM bar, read bar, and the write bar. IOM bar is one single signal on one single pin. Either the signal is low, M bar, or it is high, IO. So the level of the signal indicates whether it is a M bar, memory related operation, or IO, the IO type of operation. Its value will indicate what kind of operation. Read bar and write bar both are the low activated signals. So hence, they both when are 00 or when both are 11, this will lead to an invalid operation. Since we assume that only one operation can happen at one time, either a memory read or a memory write, either the IO read or a IO write. So accordingly, if you see the signal 001, IOM bar is 0, read bar is 0, and write bar is 0. 0 means memory, this 0 means read bar, and this 1 on the write, that means it is not active. Read is active and memory is active. So this signal is called as a memory read. The next line shows 010, read bar is 1, so read is not active, write is active, and memory is active. So it's a memory write. So is it about the IO read and IO write. So now if you look at these status signals, these status signals are IOM bar S1 and S0. So the values of these status signal will indicate what kind of operation is going on inside the processor. This S0, S1, S11 and IOM bar S0, this indicates opcode fetch. The next 010, memory read, memory write. 110 is IO read, then IO write. 111, it is a interrupt acknowledge, and finally the halt. So these are the different operations that are indicated by these bit combinations. Finally, we have the serial IO signals. The serial IO is serial communication. The data can come into the processor either through the data bus, which is a parallel communication with the microprocessor, or bit by bit, one bit at a time over these lines, which are called as a serial communication lines. On the 8085, there are two serial lines, one SID and SOD. Serial input data, serial output data. So data will come serially in or out serially, a bit by bit. So 8085 has the facility of serial communication with the external world. So to summarize, we have the five different classes or classification of the signals: power and the frequency signals, which are the VCC and ground, pin number 40 and pin number 20. Crystal is connected on pin number 1 and 2, X1 and X2. Clock out is for the other peripheral devices. The address and the data, there are 16 address lines and 8 data lines. Interrupt and externally initiated signals, there are 5 interrupt and 1 interrupt acknowledged, and the others are called as the externally initiated signals. Status and the control signals, they indicate the status of the operation, what kind of operation might go on inside the microprocessor, and the control signals indicates what kind of operation the processor will do once the certain bits are selected. Finally, the serial communication signals, these are the SID, serial in and serial out. So that's all in this video. So in the next video, we'll see the architecture of the 8085.